In this screencast, I'm going to describe some of the reasons that we've prepared screencasts for chemical engineering courses at the University of Colorado and made them available online. And the location of these screencasts on learnchemie.com, as well as on YouTube and iTunes U, and there are various forms that are, as you can see, in general are handwritten. They're short, they describe some process, some example problem in chemical engineering. For those of you who teach, you would like to get this type of feedback from students where they talk about lectures, they really like the textbook. These are the kind of comments that certainly would be appreciated if you teach, but in general, they're not the kind of comments we receive in our courses. However, these are indeed direct quotes from anonymous student feedback in the semester in our courses where we ask them about screencasts, the fact that in a thermodynamics course, they say they love the screencast, they think they're incredibly useful, unbelievably effective. This is part of our motivation for preparing screencasts. So what is a screencast? It's not someone at a board lecturing for 50 minutes on a number of topics. Instead, it's a short video, might be explaining a diagram or explaining how to use a certain type of software, solving an example problem, introducing a topic. And these are made on a tablet PC using screen capture software, Camtasia. They're typically in the order of 3 to 10 minutes. And they cover just one topic. That's an important distinction from the lecture. Also, they do not include a person. They strictly show the screen capture. So why screencast? Well, certainly some of the advantages over a textbook is that you can use color, but you can also introduce things sequentially that's more difficult to do in a textbook. For example, an equation in thermodynamics where we can indicate what this term is equal to and then slowly indicate the other term, and then the things that are shown here were done sequentially, so this lines that are in the last part here were not all introduced at once, but they're introduced one at a time and explained as they're introduced. Similarly, if we were talking about something like a triple effect evaporator, if this was in a textbook, what we would see is a diagram, black and white, showing a triple effect evaporator completely, and then lower in the page or on the next page would be a description of that diagram, and this can certainly create cognitive overload for someone trying to both visually look at the figure and then read the text. Much more effective if the figure is presented with a oral description in the screencast and text is not also written down. So we can do things sequentially with color, and I won't show the sequential process, but you can look at a screencast to see this. The idea is we start with the diagram in the upper right corner here, and then we step by step add the various other parts, add the flow streams, and use color to make it easier to distinguish where the flow is going. So why use screencasts? Well, certainly there are studies that say they improve student learning, and that's one of the motivation. From a student's viewpoint, the fact they're available 24/7 is a big difference over the need to get to office hours at a certain time to get an explanation of a topic. Also, unlike in class, students can control the pace. They can start them, stop them, replay them. And as I showed earlier, students very definitely like them and use them without being assigned them. They're short, sort of focused on one topic. This makes them very modular. You can pick one and then use number 4 and number 12. Very flexible. They're sustainable once they're prepared and posted online. They can be used for a long time. If a mistake is identified, they can be corrected. It doesn't require printing the next version of the textbook to correct the mistakes. I'll present just a couple examples that demonstrate their value. In this particular high school, they went to a flipped classroom concept, meaning what traditionally was done at home. homework problems, for example, is done in class. What's traditionally done in class, delivering information, is done at home via videos, screencasts, and they saw a dramatic drop in the failure rate in their courses when they started doing this. A controlled study is part of a PhD thesis that looked at one topic, chemical equilibrium, and compared a 50-minute lecture to a 50-minute lecture plus 11-minute screencast. So just an additional 11 minutes, but in the form of a screencast. The pretests showed these two groups were equally good or bad. They answered 3.1 out of 14 questions. The post-test on the topic showed a small improvement for the 50-minute lecture, but adding just an additional 11 minutes of a screencast caused a much larger improvement, so that the additional number correct more than doubled. If you look at the difference, there's 5 more correct with the screencast, there's 2 more correct after the lecture. So a really dramatic difference by using screencasts. One of the other reasons that we think they're valuable and useful is they can be easy to prepare. We do a single recording. In other words, we do not do multiple takes to try and make it perfect. This means the preparation time can be relatively short. We can certainly pause at times to write something down. So just like I paused, I could write something on the tablet with a pen and then resume. I can scroll back to show something previously. And then we can post-process. We can remove dead times during the recording. If we make an error, we can cut it out. We can also add call-outs and highlights or zoom in on some figure, for example, to make it clearer. We have prepared screencasts for chemical engineering courses because studies also show they're effective for student learning.